Even though there's a lot of hardware in the Foundation Library and more coming out all the time with future updates, you still might want to add your own. So follow along in this next lesson in working with Microvellum, and I'll show you how we can do that. Okay, so let's get started on adding a new hinge inside of this project. Now this is going to be pretty simple. We're going to use something that's already existing. The idea here is that we just need the correct machining as we send this out to production. So maybe the diameter of the holes are going to be different. We can adjust the cup depth if we want to. And we could even go as far as changing the entire 3D drawing, but we're not going to go that far in this video, but I'll show you where you need to go to make that happen if that is what you're trying to do. First, we're going to go inside of our project spec group and double check which hinge we're actually using. The hardware wizard, we can verify that. We can see we have that Bloom 110 degree full overlay knock-in hinge. Okay, so that's our current hinge that's being used. Now we can go into the material file and we're going to copy that hinge up to the project level. Into the hardware library, and now under the hinges folder, we'll find our Bloom hinges. And there's our 110 degree full overlay knock-in. So we're going to just right click and copy that selection to the project level. And the reason we're doing it this way is because we want to keep those hardware machine tokens. We see we have our bore token for the cup and the other bore token for the other two holes that we need for our hinges. Before we start editing that, I'm going to double click in here and give this hinge a new name. Obviously, you can name it whatever you want, but as long as it's something different than what we currently have. Now we'll go back and edit these machine tokens. So in this scenario, we're going to leave the diameter the same, but we are going to increase the depth of this route. So currently we have it set up in metric. If you wanted to just add another half a millimeter, you could do that. Or if you wanted to keep it in imperial, give yourself 9/16. Either way, it doesn't have to be formula driven. You can have that be a static value. So now our drill depth is different. And we're also going to change the diameter of those two holes. So instead of it being 8 millimeter, we'll just change it to 5. And we're going to keep the depth the same on that. And we don't need to worry about the X and the Y locations or the distance between holes. Everything there is fine, just change the diameter. But now that we have our new hinge added to the project level folder, let's go back into our hardware wizard and now tell Toolbox that we're going to be using that hinge inside of this project. Okay, so our new hinge is selected, close out of that and redraw our product. So as we redraw the product, we see we have the machining. That's good. That's really the most important thing, right, as we get the send out to the shop, but we don't have that 3D block shown anymore. So I'll get into how we can get that back, but first let me go into the part in 2D and we can just double check our machining here. Okay, so verifying the diameter of the hole, is it 5 millimeter? And just hovering our mouse over that layer, we can see that the bore depth is 0.5625. And also verify that doing it this way. So the hardware machine tokens are working correctly. Now the key is to make sure that you have DWG files with the same name as the hardware in the library, or in this case, inside of the project. Now that goes for 2D and 3D DWG files. Here we're just going to work on the 3D drawing, but this is the way that Toolbox can make sure it finds the correct block so your product draws correctly. Let's go to the Help menu, browse to factory data, and we're going to open up our graphics folder and then into the hardware. You can just type in 3 to get to our 3D drawing files. So we're looking for that hinge that we first had set up inside of this project. That 110 degree full overlay knock-in, and we're just going to make a copy of that and paste it right back inside of this folder. Like I said, the key is to make sure that it matches the same name as what's inside of your project. And now when we go back to redraw our product, that hinge will show up. Okay, now what if we have this hinge that we're using and the spacing of our 5 millimeter holes is a little bit different than what's currently set up in our hardware machine tokens. So just going back into that same piece of hardware. And now going into that bore token with those 5 millimeter holes. So the X and the Y and the Z values that we see here are based off of the actual AutoCAD 3D drawing. Just for the sake of this video, we're not going to adjust the actual 3D block. We're just going to adjust the hardware machine tokens. Just going to stomp on this value too, just to make it easy. We're going to, for simple math, we'll go -1. So this is 1 inch away from the center of the cup in Y. And then also the other direction in Y, positive 1 inch. Now the distance between holes is going to be 2 inches. After we've redrawn the product, you can see that the holes have been spaced out the way that we've set them up in our hardware machine token. Not matching exactly what our drawing block is, but that's fine for now. We can, like I said, go back into that DWG file and make that adjustment. So to do that, go back into our browse factory data, the graphics folder, and find that new copied hinge. So here we are inside of that 3D AutoCAD drawing of our new Bloom hinge, and change it to a top view. And you can see when we're adding these pieces of hardware from the top view, we want it to look as if it were inside of the door when it's on the machine being cut out. So right now the door is face down. We're looking at the backside of it with this hinge coming out like that. Hopefully that makes sense. But that's the way that you need to insert these pieces of hardware in the position it would be when these parts are laying flat on your CNC machine. I'm just going to start a line at our 0, 0 point. I know it's not easy to see, but that line that we have right there is going right to our 0, 0, 0. And that you can see here would be right at the surface on the back of that door. Okay, now if you're into 3D modeling and you wanted to change this all around, you can. I'm not an expert when it comes to that, so I'm just going to show you what happens if we were to just delete some of this stuff. So it's slightly different than it was. Let's go ahead and save that. Okay, so now even though we've made those changes to our 3D AutoCAD drawing of this hinge block, you'll notice inside of the drawing, it still looks the same. Okay, so this is going back to our purge command, and we do have some more documentation and videos about purging items inside of your drawing. But the idea here is that we delete these drawing blocks, and then you can use the purge command. Find the block that we had just deleted, purge that item, and now when we redraw the product, Toolbox goes back to that DWG file and pulls it back in, but now being updated with those edits. And if this was a brand new hinge with a brand new 3D drawing block, you would just paste that drawing into your graphics and hardware folder and make sure the name matches up with what's in your library. And that brings us to the end of another training lesson in Microvellum Toolbox. Thanks for joining us, and see you on the next one.